All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to be talking about the latest turbo upgrade offering that is coming from Vargas Turbo. I know we haven't talked about them in a while, and several years ago they released a bunch of stock location turbo upgrades that they've kind of been cranking out since then, but now they've got their newest option that is actually a top mount turbo kit that reuses the factory electronic wastegate. And so that's major. I mean, especially if you know me and my build on my 440i, you know I'm a fan of that style of turbo upgrade implementation. And they actually went about it a very unique way that opens up multiple other turbo options depending on your goals. So we're gonna go ahead and talk about their new kit and everything as far as how it works and what kind of options you might be interested in. And hopefully you guys find this video useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So this is a look at their product page, and I figured this would be an easier view to take a look at what we've got going on here because, you know, there's a lot of stuff to discuss. So if you guys like this view and this style of video, let me know. Anyway, so here's the top mount turbo kit, and it looks very familiar. Let's open up this picture, and you can see they've got the manifold where the turbo mounts, so that looks pretty normal. They've got their downpipe, they've got their charge pipe. They've got, you know, basically everything that you would expect for this kind of kit. However, they're using a precision turbo, and this is something that isn't common with kits that try to use the factory electronic wastegate because these turbos don't come with an internal gate, and that's usually what companies try to do. So how does this work? Well, what you see up here is basically their solution. So this is a turbo smart straight gate, and let me show you how this works. So here's kind of, again, the TurboSmart product page. And you can see, basically, it looks like a typical wastegate where you've got, you know, the big housing for all the springs. But instead of it being mounted directly on your exhaust manifold, it's mounted in this little straight pipe. And if you look inside of the straight pipe, you'll see that there's a butterfly valve. So the wastegate works the same as far as opening and closing a wastegate, but instead of operating a valve directly, it's hooked onto this linkage, and then this linkage rotates. Let's see, where's the view? So this linkage rotates as the wastegate extends, and that's what opens up that butterfly valve to release excess exhaust gases. So really unique way to implement it. I was not even aware that this was a thing until Vargas started talking about it, but it works really well. And especially if you consider the biggest issue with internally gated turbos, you'll realize that this is a really good solution. So again, let's switch over to looking at my stock turbo on the left versus my EFR turbo on the right. And the EFRs were pretty common for these kits. Like on my OG Dock Race kit, it came with EFR turbos. Big Boost also sells kits with EFR turbos. And these are very common, high quality, internally gated turbos. So you can basically retrofit a bracket that mounts up your stock electronic wastegate, and it'll open and close this flap and work just like the stock turbo. Now, the issue is the size. So as you can see, like really this comparison was to show the turbine wheel. So you can see the exhaust wheel on the stock turbo is wimpy wimpy, and the exhaust on my upgraded turbo is hefty hefty. And, you know, that's where majority of your power band comes in, you know, pulling things up higher into the rev range. But the actual flap for the exhaust for the wastegate, it's about the same size, actually. Looking at it now, I don't think I even noticed that before, but the flap is very small. The issue with that is the whole purpose of that wastegate flap is to bleed off extra exhaust gases. So as you're making a lot of power and flowing a lot of air through your engine, you need that flap to be able to get rid of all the extra gases to control boost effectively. If you can't, if it's wide open and it's still not bleeding off enough exhaust gas, then you can run into boost creep, where boost will continue to rise and kind of go out of control, even though the wastegate's wide open. So that's usually the issue that you run into with these internally gated turbos is, you know, they just don't support as much power. And when you're pushing higher boost levels, it's hard to control how much boost it's making. The other thing just with EFR turbos in general is they don't like being overspun. So if you run them really hard, if you run into issues where it has to spin faster to make the same boost, you know, running into restrictions with your intake or exhaust and things like that, they tend to fail and explode. So it's, you know, a high quality turbo, it spools really quickly, but it's also sensitive to running within its operating range. Otherwise, you can definitely run into problems. So that's why a lot of people like running the precision turbos, for example, because those can be pushed really hard, way out of their efficiency range. They still seem to make more power. And of course, they're constantly making newer and newer turbo upgrades every year. So back to what we're looking at here, you can see this butterfly valve is huge, right? I think this one on their kit, they said it's 60 millimeters versus the one on my stock turbo or my upgraded turbo, I'm sure is probably half that size. So this can flow a lot of air. And if this is wide open, you'll have basically no boost. So you can go anywhere from zero PSI up to whatever your heart's content is, and this will be able to manage it. Now, what they've done is put a bracket right here. So you'll be able to remove this linkage from the TurboSmart wastegate, or I don't even know if it even comes with the TurboSmart wastegate, but it has an adapter here and a mounting bracket. So you can attach the stock electronic wastegate and then mount that onto this rotating arm. So once you plug it in, it'll open and close just like it's a stock turbo. Won't know any different other than it's actuating this flap instead. So yeah, very cool way to implement this. Very cool technology from TurboSmart. Now let's go back to our turbo kit. So yeah, this is where the actual wastegate will mount. And you can see the downpipe kind of has this upper main piping that will come off of the exhaust from the turbo itself. And then this one comes off of the wastegate. So the wastegate should be mounted between here on the exhaust manifold and here on the actual downpipe. And then it comes with two clamps to basically clamp it in between. I think they have a picture of it in here as I was scrolling through. There we go. Yeah, so you can see the exhaust manifold and then the wastegate basically sits right between, and you'll need your electronic wastegate to be mounted down here. I'm not sure, maybe it'll come with an extension harness or something, because this seems kind of far from where the factory wastegate plugs in, and maybe you might want to put some sheathing or something around it, because all of this is going to get very hot, obviously. So, you know, some things to consider. Again, this isn't my turbo kit. I haven't ran this before, just looking at the design, but it seems like definitely a cool option to make this work for a high horsepower capable setup using the factory electronic wastegate. So very, very cool. And then if we click over here, we can see the picture of the mount. So this is where your stock electronic wastegate will fit in. It'll mount onto here. And then you'll thread this onto the wastegate rod, and that's what will actually actuate the flap by rotating it open and closed. And it looks like it comes with a little bit of a sock as well, I guess, to protect it. So yeah, lots of good ideas throughout here. Now, reading through their notes, you can see there are a couple other things they want to highlight. So first of all, it's 100% made in the US by them. They actually hired a fabricator, I guess not so recently anymore, but they've had somebody in their facility to do all of their welding and fabrication for them. So that's the person that, you know, apparently created this kit, fabricates all of the exhaust manifolds and boost piping and things like that. So 100% made in the USA, not a Chinese product, since that's such a sensitive topic nowadays. The other thing they mentioned is that this is an equal length manifold, so all of the runners should be the same length. And so you can see, I mean, no matter what, you're gonna have a really long runner coming from cylinder six, right? It's gotta come all the way from the back of the engine up to the front in a location where the turbo can actually be mounted. So all of these other runners are very long, kind of swooping really low and stuff to try to make all of the runners the same length. But for people that have been looking for that and wanting an equal length manifold, this is going to be one of the options that meets that design requirement. And then, as they noted, it reuses your factory actuator. So again, if you've got a more conventional turbo kit that uses external wastegates, one of the big things people are hesitant about is basically getting all the hoses connected, what kind of hoses you use, making sure you use something high quality that won't melt and stuff, and everything's plumbed up properly. And then, of course, you need a boost controller. So the one I typically recommend is a Motive Reflex, but that adds additional cost, wiring, tuning, and stuff like that. Whereas with this one, in theory, you should just be able to plug it in, hook up the electronic wastegate to the factory connector, and everything just works. You tune your DME just like factory, especially if you've got like a DI-only setup. Maybe you've got a Dorch Stage 2 or like an upgraded cam and injectors and stuff, and you don't have port injection or any of the other things that would need a Motive Reflex. This is a really easy way to make it pretty much plug and play just like a hybrid turbo would be. So yeah, again, I'm a fan of this style of setup for sure. Now, as we scroll down, they also have a couple different turbo options. So you can see a bunch of precision turbos, 6670, 6870, 7275. You know, at this point, I wouldn't really recommend a Gen 2 turbo anymore. I would just go ahead and recommend a next gen for most of our cars and most of, you know, the goals that people have. I think a 6670 is plenty. A 6870 is good as well. It'll just be a little more laggy, but the new ones can support like 1200 horsepower or something. So most people aren't shooting that high, but maybe if you're looking at a turbo kit like this, there's your goal and there's your turbo option to help you hit that goal. And you've got a couple different AR options. Personally, I would just go with the 0.96. Our cars flow a lot of air. It's a big 3 liter inline six, so there's no issues running an AR that large. Now, you can see the turbo kit is pretty expensive. And I think a lot of it has to do with the turbo options. The turbos are expensive. Also, the Turbo Smart straight gates are pretty expensive. And also just the fabrication of this, being everything's in the USA. They also mentioned there's like no silicone or anything in the piping. So everything is an exact fit using clamps. So you don't have to worry about boost hoses popping off and stuff like that. So really high quality, really good design details, but that adds cost. So if you want your turbo kit to look like this and not have a bunch of silicone hoses and couplers and stuff like mine does, and everything pretty much just looks perfectly fitted, that just kind of comes with the territory. But I mean, it looks cool. It does look cool. You can see also the actual charge pipe. It's kind of like one of those high runners. So it'll be pretty much right behind your radiator shroud, kind of mounted up high, really easy to access and work on, and everything will be right in front of you in the engine bay. So yeah, definitely a cool kit and cool design for sure. Now, as we scroll down a little bit more, there are a couple other options. So the first one, getting the ESTA calibration, which I've made a couple videos about this on my channel, either with my turbo DIYs or just standalone videos about calibrating your wastegate. I don't really think this is needed. Basically, all you're going to want to do is basically close the wastegate, set the wastegate arm so it's extended 26 millimeters, and then tighten everything down. And that's what the perfect location will be. So, you know, if you do that yourself, you can even do it off of the car probably before you actually install everything, and it should work perfectly fine. If it doesn't work, it'll throw a code and you can make minor adjustments to get it set up. But if you don't want to deal with that and trying to measure it and making sure it's right, they offer this option to make sure it comes with the wastegate already set at the right position. You can also get a velocity stack if you want. You also can, of course, get the hot parts coded, which I definitely highly recommend. Like I said, with your wastegate right there, things are going to be getting hot right next to some really sensitive electrical components. Not that it doesn't do that in the factory location, but you'll probably want to just be aware of that, especially with an upgraded turbo. So getting the manifold coated and all the hot parts, you know, the downpipe and stuff, will just give you a little more peace of mind for all of the wires and everything that are in that area, not to be getting all of that ambient heat. You can also coat the cold parts. So you saw like in their picture, they had the charge pipe powder coated black. So if that's an option you want, you can do that as well. It also comes with a turbo blanket and stuff. Let's see, you can also get different downpipes. And I think this is pretty cool. A lot of people are concerned with running a stock exhaust, but they want to run the biggest downpipe possible into the stock exhaust. It doesn't really make a difference because everything tapers down no matter what. So if you don't want to run a stock exhaust and you want all of your piping to be bigger, they have an option for that. One is, of course, the factory that just fits the stock exhaust. The next one is a factory with a 4-inch V-band assembly, so you can make a 4-inch cat-back all the way back, whatever you want. You'll probably have to get that custom-made since people don't really offer that, but this gives you the option. And then the last one is just a turndown, which is usually what I recommend if you're worried about the stock exhaust. Just run a turndown. The piping is shorter. You can run whatever diameter you want, and then you're not worried about any restrictions in the factory mid-pipe or cat-back. So that's definitely cool to see it as an option with the kit, and especially, like I said, with everything being cut exactly to fit, they want to make sure they make it right based on your goals. And then the last thing is the charge pipe, which something we don't typically see because most kits come with silicone couplers, so you can just kind of adjust your piping and make everything fit. Here they need to know, because depending on your manifold, it's going to fit differently. I don't know if you guys have seen this, but certain manifolds space out everything differently or locate the throttle body in different positions. So that's what they're asking here, whether you have an EOS manifold or an OEM manifold that keeps it in the stock location. Also, they're noting that the factory option, if you have a stock intake manifold, does not account for the extra space that comes with running, you know, a port injection spacer. So that pushes things out as well. So just make sure they're aware of exactly what your setup is so they can set your charge pipe with the right position and length and stuff like that. But yeah, you know, overall, again, I think this is a really cool option. I like the idea. It's expensive, but if this is a priority for you, then it's probably worth the money, especially because there aren't really a lot of other turbo options like this, maybe just one now. But curious to hear you guys' thoughts. I think this is something that I'll be keeping an eye on. We'll see if they get this installed on their cars and run some times and see how it performs. There's a B58 and S58 option. So whichever platform you have, 340i, 440i, Supra, M3, M4, there are options like this for everybody. Only difference is if your car has an S58, you'll have to disable one of the electronic wastegates in your tune for everything to work like factory. But for us B58 guys that came with single turbos, it'll just be plug and play. So yeah, hopefully this gives you the information you guys were looking for. And I think that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.